Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to VGW. It's Brad Johnson here on commentary for the very first time. Then we got a great match for you here. The first match tonight will be a tag match. We have the Clown and Chaos. The Undead will be taking on the newly formed team of Cake and the Artist, the Dream Team. And oh, and here they come right now. In case you missed VGW Apocalypse, Cake defeated his former tag partner Mr. Bishop to earn the right to cash in their rematch clause. Cake has chosen his partner to be the Artist, and since Cake won that match, they will be able to cash that in at any time. VGW Originals, the Clown and Chaos teaming up, taking on the Artist and Cake. Nice clothesline there by the Artist. A reversal from the Clown. All three of these superstars, the Clown, the Artist, and nice reversal there. But as I was saying, the Clown, the Artist, and Chaos have all come from New York Extreme Wrestling. The Artist was there from the day the doors opened in 2000 to the day the doors closed in 2007. And his entire time there, he only won the New York Extreme Wrestling Television Championship 3 times. Chaos is a former New York Extreme Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. And the Clown was only there for a short amount of time, never winning any championships. Nice power slam there by the Artist. Chaos in the corner there. Oh, wait, what a nice reversal there. Cake watching his partner, his mentor. Oh no, nice clothesline by Chaos. For those of you who are wondering where my broadcast partner is, Jason Klimo, he is a wrestling legend, the Great Mongo. He's going back out on the road to wrestle again. I mean, doing what he does best. And we will miss him here at the commentary booth. He's been my partner for the past almost 20 years. You know, we've commentated together and back in AFW where he also used to wrestle. But, you know, I'm going to be going solo here, a la Joey Styles and Rick C. Oh, nice German suplex, but a rope break right there. Oh, nice swanton straight to the back of Chaos. Cake is definitely a tag team general in this company right now. He's definitely been making strides as a tag team competitor. A lot of people are wondering how would he do as a singles competitor. Oh, nice clothesline takedown by the Clown. Oh, wow. Nice shot to the face right there. Can Cake win it? Oh, no, only a one count. That was a nice kick right there by Cake. Oh, that springboard senton. Nice jawbreaker there by the Clown. The Clown is a former WCW champion and a former World Heavyweight Champion here in VGW. Nice moonsault there by Cake. And that standing. Oh, what is this? Oh, a standing 450 right there. Can he get the win? Oh, but Chaos breaks it off. Kagan's been through a lot with his former tag partner, his cousin, Mr. Bishop. He's finally seen the light. He's back to being who he is, who he used to be. What's this? Oh, nice shot to the face right there. It's good to see Kate back in good spirits after that huge dark cloud has finally been lifted over his career. Oh my gosh, nice shooting star press by Kate there. Could get the win here. One, two. Oh no, the kick out. Oh no, what's he setting up for here? What's he setting up for? Oh no, pineapple surprise, oh my gosh. Just took the clown's head clean off. Oh no, but Chaos breaks it up after one. And look at the artist with a bulldog there. Check out the back and forth between Cake and the clown right now. Cake's going up top. What's he going for here? Oh no! Well, he was probably going for a Hurricanrana, but didn't fully connect there. Oh, nice knee strike right there. Cake preventing clown from getting a tag. Nice headlock there, but lets him out. Clown's in a bad position here. What's this? Oh no! Oh, the Pride Parade! Nice tandem move from the Cake and the artist. Oh my gosh, the Pride Parade. Could this be it? And that's it. The Dream Team wins. The Dream Team wins with the Pride Parade. Oh my gosh. Impressive showing for these two teams here, especially Cake and the artist, who are now going to start their ascent, in the tag team division. Cake and the artist celebrating their win right here. But now here's the question. They can cash in the rematch clause at any time. But the question is, when will they cash it in? All right, up next, we got Thomas Salami from GTS fame going against Dark Dog. Now, Dark Dog hasn't been seen a whole lot lately since a few weeks ago, since he had a match against Stink. In a pretty decisive match. Be all end all, it was pretty much a squash. But here comes Tommy Salami right now, who seems to be riding high since his win over Grimm at the Super Pop Memorial Show. I wonder what's next for Tommy. Oh wait, hold on. That's Dark Dog. What's he doing? Say, Dark Dog doesn't want to wait. Turn around, look behind you, Tommy. Oh no. Oh, that full Nelson drop right there. Straight to the floor. Oh, Dark Dog is just attacking relentlessly. Oh no, the ref has rung the bell, and now these two are in a match right now. Oh, but oh, Tommy Salami trying to mount a comeback here. Oh no, but that shot to the head, that reversal, that clothesline. What is wrong with this guy? This guy is a maniac. And Tommy Salami come back from this. Nice reversal there. He's got him in power slam position. Oh, but a reversal to a DDT. What's going to happen in this match? Got him in the corner there. Oh, no. Nice power slam. With the assist of the turnbuckle. Knee drop straight to the face of Tommy Salami. Oh, but Tommy Salami is not going to give up that easily. Nice reversal there. Dark Dog made a splash on the scene a few weeks ago by defeating Stink in a pretty much a squash match. We haven't seen much of him lately, but look at his mask. I mean, yeah, it's definitely been torn since the last time we saw it. Dark Dog stomping away on Tommy Salami here, but Tommy Salami making a reversal here. Going for that. Oh, that backbreaker there. Ooh, chop to the skull. Can Tommy Salami mount a decent comeback and take care of Dark Dog? Oh, what's this? Oh, say, Dark Dog couldn't support the weight of Tommy Salami there. With that body slam. Back on their feet here. And, oh, look at that hog lock. Nice hog lock by Tommy Salami. He's going up to the second rope here. Body splash on Dark Dog. Can he get the pin? Oh, not even a one count. Shot to the head there by Tommy Salami. Now he's cheering and taunting. Tommy Salami may just get the best of Dark Dog. We never know. We've seen stranger things happening here in VGW. Dark Dog with the reversal. But Tommy catches him. Oh, he's got him in a turnbuckle there. Oh, but that's reversal. Oh! Dark Dog returning the favor in a nice clothesline to the back. Nice fireman's carry from Tommy Salami. Oh, what's this? Oh, no, pile driver. Pile driver on Tommy Salami. Let's take a look at that again. Oh, right on his hand. Oh man, it's a very dangerous move there. Could this be it for Tommy Salami? But he's not going for the pin. What's he doing? Oh, come on, not again, not again. Come on now. Oh no. Tommy Salami's neck may have been broken there. Two pile drivers is insane. There's a reason that this move has been illegal for some time now. Can we finally end this match? End this suffering. Yes, and it's over. I feel bad for Tommy Salami, but Dark Dog has won this match. Thank God. We don't need anyone getting injured on this roster right now. Tommy Salami was able to mount an offense, but in the end, Dark Dog took him out with not one, but two pile drivers. Here's your winner, ladies and gentlemen, Dark Dog. What's he doing? Oh, come on, man. Leave him alone. The match is over. Just stop this right now. Someone get security out here, please. This is insane. What's this? Another pop. No! No, no. Come on, stop this. Somebody get security out here now. Tommy Salami could be injured. Not another one. Not another power driver. Please stop this. Oh, no. He's busted open now. This is insane. That was completely unnecessary.
As of Apocalypse, Quentin Credible has been suspended for putting his hands on me last week. Now, over the weekend, I saw Status Quo crying on Twitter saying that I finally broke him, and now he wants to retire. But Status, why are you hiding behind social media? If you really want to make it official, I'll invite you to Christmas Slam so that your adoring fans can hear from your mouth that you're giving up on him.
What you saw there was footage from earlier this evening, before the show even went on air. Pete Baxter laid out a challenge for Status Quo to appear at Christmas Slam to give a formal retirement speech. But up next, we got The Fallen versus the returning Seth O'Riser. Here's The Fallen. He was in the third season of VGW NXT. He finished in second place, losing to Kevin Riley. What a lot of people don't know about The Fallen is that he was previously employed by VGW back in 2006, portraying the zombie. He was in a faction known as The Darkness, which was led by Damian Jones, teaming up also with Invader, who is now The Bully. Here he comes, Steven's tag partner, the return of Seth O'Riser. Seth O'Riser has yet to win any championships here in VGW, but, well, still wondering what his future is going to be here in this company. Very mysterious figure he is. All right, let's get this matchup underway. We got The Fallen versus Seth O'Riser. And the bell is rung, and let's see what's going to go down. The Fallen Irish whip into that corner there. Irish whip into another one. Wait, no, back into the rope. Back suplex, but a reversal there by Seth O'Riser. Northern Lights suplex takes down The Fallen. Seth O'Riser picking him up for a suplex there. Ankle caught that top rope a little bit. How would that affect The Fallen's performance in this match? Nice fist drop, straight into the paint. The Fallen fighting out of it. Another Irish rip. But he throws it back into the ring. Seth Rizer climbing up to the top rope there. He's not capitalizing. What's going on here? Nice reversal there. He's got him in the corner. Elbow shot straight to the back, and here he goes, picking him up for a snake eyes. Oh, right there on the turnbuckle. Open. Instant recovery from the fall in there. Nice back chop there. He's going for a twist of fate. Oh! Can he get the win right here? One. Oh no, only a one count on the falling. Seth the Rizer pandering to the crowd right now. Nice clothesline taking, falling down. Like Seth the Rizer setting up for something else. Oh no, code breaker. Can he get the win right here? Only a two count. Nice arm drag there by the fallen. So he's going for a DDT, but Seth the Rizer reverse it. Belly to belly, but an eye right there. Oh, a kick. Nice spinning back kick by the fallen. Taking Seth the Rizer off his feet. The fallen on the second rope there. What's he about to do here? Nice hurricanrana. These two are going back and forth and back and forth. Who's going to win this contest tonight? Nice. Oh, reversal to a Russian. Excuse me, a reverse DDT. A signature spine buster from the fallen. He could be setting up for that screw pile driver. Oh my gosh. Oh, that sit out pile driver. Calls it the screw. Yeah, one, two, oh. Man, what a kick out there. The fallen is feeling the electricity in this building right now. Will it be enough to get him the victory? Nice reversal there. Going back and forth. Neither one of them is letting up in this contest. Oh wait, Seth the Rizer is going for a choke slam. Oh wow. What's this? Got him in the power slam position, but oh no, he reversed into a DDT. And Seth the Rizer is sizing him up. Oh, another cold breaker from Seth the Rizer. One, two. Oh, kick out. That could have been it. That could have been over for the fallen, but he kicks out. Seth the Rizer looks a little pissed off right now. Got him in power slam position. Oh no, right into the turnbuckle there. And straight to the mat. Springboard leg drop, right across the throat of the fallen. Another twist of fate. Oh no, I think that busted him open. This could spell the end for the fallen. And that's it. Seth the Rizer with the victory. Impressive showing by both of these men. But in the end, only one can be the winner, and that winner is Seth the Rizer. Seth Rollins has always been a strange individual. But Strange got him the victory. Let's move on to our next match. Coming up, we've got MJ Appleballs versus Matthew. And these two have had a bit of a rivalry that culminated at Superpop Memorial Show. It actually started with Matthew's brother, Skull Crusher, after he squashed him in a very quick match on an episode of VGW this year. But last season. MJ Appleballs was revealed to be the masked man terrorizing his family, Matthew's family. And it looks like Matthew has to start this early. he's coming out here. Oh no! Taking out Appleballs early. Hopefully that this match right here will be the definitive end of MJ Appleballs' vendetta against Matthew's family. Well, that's if the match even makes it into the ring. Appleballs making a beeline to the ring, getting ready to attack. Yes, now this match has started. Oh wow, there's a setup for right here. Oh no, no, no. Oh, DDT right on the apron. That's definitely gonna lock your lights out. I'm getting tongue-tied. Knock your lights out. That's my broadcast partner's here. I know he has something to say about this. I know for a fact that Jason Klimo really hates MJ Appleballs. Like, seriously. He's like, what's he doing in VGW anyway? He sucks. Yeah, well. I disagree. I think MJ Appleballs has a future in this business. So forget about whatever Jason's talking about. Alright, I'm sorry, back to the action. I took a little tangent there. But these two are getting back into the action. Need to get back into the ring right now. Referee's up on a four count, trying to keep MJ Appleballs from going out there. Nice step, Mary. Ooh! Kick to the back. MJ Appleballs going up top. What's he setting up for right here? Nice drop kick to the back. Can't MJ Appleballs really? Oh wait! Just a random jumping DDT. Can he take Matthew out with it? No, only a two count. Is slowly slipping into darkness as of late, and it looks like that may serve him well in this match. Oh, that nice side slam right there. That could be it for Appleballs there, but no, he kicks out. Appleballs rolling out the ring, trying to get away from the action right now. Oh, just Irish whip Matthew into those steps. Oh, missed that elbow drop. Nice reversal there. MJ Appleballs has not won the championship. Oh, that nice spear though. Yeah, MJ Appleballs prides himself on being associated with Curt Hawkins. But you know, he's no longer in VGW. We all saw what happened. Matthew not taking this crap anymore. Send him up for, oh, what's this? Oh, nice neck breaker there by Matthew. For those of you who don't know, Matthew's birthday was this past Monday, on December 4th. This victory may be a great Christmas present for him. I mean, birthday present. Oh, that DDT, that same DDT. Can he take him out here? Two, and it's over already. Matthew wins this match. Oh, this puts an end to MJ Epelbaum's targeting Matthew's family. I mean, it's not Matthew's fault that MJ Epelbaum's lost to Skull Crusher in like almost less than a minute or two to a single headbutt. I guess that's why they call him Skull Crusher. Say the highlight of MJ Epelbaum's career is his win against Skull Crusher at Superpop Memorial Show, but I still think that's hope for him though. I do. But ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Matthew. Our main event, ladies and gentlemen, but we will coming up have words from Charles Dante Dillinger. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, our VGW GTS champion, Charles Dante Dillinger, the Monster Hunter from Vancouver. He has a few words for that mysterious attacker, who we now find out is Aldis Heidenreich. And we found out at Apocalypse that he was the one behind Vinny Torres' capture at the Superpop Memorial Show. And he claims to be a Monster Hunter as well, so is he trying to get a new trophy, or is he trying to experiment on him? We don't know, but we'll find out soon enough. But let's hear what Charles Dante Dillinger has to say. Ladies and gentlemen, I need to address this 1980s British pedo flanked by his two roided up Shockmasters, who by the way have the accuracy of an actual stormtrooper because they didn't hit me enough to keep me down. Heidenreich, winning to me isn't just a mere companion. She's my life. She's my support, my second half, my one and only. I'm only half a man without her. You've ruined everything by showing your face here. And the fact that you have her captive fills my entire being with hot, boiling rage. You want my title at Christmas Slam? Come and get it. The only thing in this world that matters to me is winning. I must get her back. I will get her back. Heidenreich, you claim to be a monster hunter like me. Well, be prepared to become the hunted. Oh my God, the lights just went out. What's this? Wait. It's out of Heidenreich's cronies. Oh my God, what are they doing here? It's not an assault right now, ladies and gentlemen. Our champion has been attacked by these two huge men who associate themselves with Aldis Heidenreich. Get up, Charles, get up. Someone's gotta stop this right now. Someone's gotta stop this. Oh my gosh. Oh no. Be careful. Get up. No. He's reversing. He's going to take care of him. Look at that kick. Oh yes. Charles Dante Dillinger is fighting back, ladies and gentlemen. Nice back suplex right there. Charles Dante Dillinger has just been ambushed by these two huge guards of Aldis Heidenreich. Oh my gosh, he's just setting him up for a powerbomb. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, he's fighting out of it, yes! Oh my gosh. Oh! That massive backbreaker of Charles Dante Dillinger's took him out. He's still going for it. Just hit one of the guards with that Vancouver Crescent. Oh, look, that kill code. That rope down kill code by Charles Dante Dillinger. It looks like he's setting up for another one for the other guard. Yes, he's on top rope. He's going to do it. Kill code. Oh, no, he reversed it. Oh, no. But Charles Dante Dillinger is still fighting. He's still fighting. Oh no. Got another powerbomb attempt going here. Oh no, Baszler reverse it again. Oh, nice drop kick there. He's trying his best to fight off these guards. But the numbers game is catching up to him. Oh my gosh. Snake eyes. Oh man. This assault has gone on too far. Someone get some help down here, damn it. Another Vancouver curse. Oh my gosh. What's this? Oh no, he's... No way! Oh, that choke slam! No! Can we please get security down here? Champ is down. The champ is down, ladies and gentlemen. Can someone please get some help? This is completely wrong. They're not even signed to VGW. What the hell are they even doing here? I guess I heard the Shockmaster comment. These guys just won't stop, but neither will our champion. Oh, wow. Nice clothesline there. Oh, no. Nice power slam there. Well, I don't mean to praise his moves here, but it's quite impressive for someone who's not even a wrestler. Not even signed to VGW. This is completely unnecessary. Oh, he's fighting out of it. He's fighting back, ladies and gentlemen. He's not going to give up just yet. He's going up top. Oh, no. They cut him off with it. Nice punch to the face. And then what's he? Oh, no. No. Not the superplex. No. Dillinger, another Vancouver curse. Oh no, but what a huge choke toss right there. Oh my gosh, Dillinger's in trouble. Oh my gosh, somebody finally stop the assault. Oh man. It's like Otis Hotline like to send a message to our BGW GTS champion. Hello. We appreciate you tuning in to this episode of BGW. Tune in next Wednesday for more action. Next Wednesday will be our showcase of new superstars.